Hadley's, Brontosaurus, Plesiosaurus, Pliosaurus, Mosasaurus. Mosasaurus was my third animal. It was my third animal.
Yeah.
The first reptile. It was not brown. The first reptile and the third animal. Mosasaurus. Very short animal. Those two short things at first. Question Bullyman. I started with Bullyman. Of course, I like elephants. Actually, same to Tiger and Lion the first time. The kind of thing. Embarrassingly, I can't write all the dinosaurs. Horrend. I can't write them. What a whole paragraph. It's about 20 lines. A very long dinosaur. I only wrote Parnicosaur, Gigantoraptor, and okay, I'll tell every animal that I wrote, okay? It might take, it will not take long. Okay, let's start. First one that I ever wrote was Woolly Mammoth. Second was Saber-tooth Tiger. Third was Mosasaurus. Fourth was Carolina Parakeet. Parrot. Tali. Acopa Puffish. Siberian Unicorn. Devonian Moth. The Barring Whale. Javan Tiger. The Mandarin Large White Butterfly, the Pinta Island Tortoise, the Cleostris, Schoenberg's Deer, Terror Birds, Titanoboa, Phobromis Patricini, Woolly Rhinoceros, Platybelodon, Parvicursor, Gigantoraptor, Uteraptor. It is Carchardontosaurus, Brachiosaurus, then Brontosaurus, then the Caribbean Moxie Nasalmite, Lyoplorodon, and then Cetotherium.
Can you show me what you have written also? This one.
This is Cetotherium and a little bit of Lyoplorodon.
Other pages.
Okay, so this one is Cetotherium. This is a little bit of Lyoplorodon. And including this also, and then we have the Caribbean Monsoon Nasalmite. This is also called the Hala Rashne Americana. It's a mite that lives in the nasal cavity of the Caribbean Monsoon. The Caribbean Monsoon was also extinct. It could not adapt any other animal, so subsequently and went extinct. And then we have Brontosaurus, and then we have Brachiosaurus. This is part of
this one.
Yeah, including this. Yeah, it's a very long. It's one of the enemies of Megalodon, which also is extinct, and I'm going to write it very soon. And then we have Carchardontosaurus, which is this. We have this and this. Very young. It's a dinosaur. I have written totally 5 dinosaurs. And the next one is Uteraptor. It lived in Utah, a state of the United States. And Gigantoraptor. I guess it. I heard that this was. It was in Africa. It lived in Africa. And then we have Kargitosaur, the smallest dinosaur. We have this part and this part. It's short, but yes, it's all short. And then we have Platybalanon. So elephants grew in different groups. Like the Asian elephant is the mammoth is the relative of the Asian elephant, and the African elephant and Asian elephant is actually different. They are not the same. The African elephant is related to Platybaladon is also a different family. And then we have woolly rhinoceros. It's called woolly because it lived during the same time of mammoths. And then we have frog-bearing Pachyseni, the rodent. It's the biggest rodent. If it still exists, it would be much dangerous. It would bite off your head. Titanoboa, if it still exists, it would have been the biggest snake. It's the great ancestor of the giant anaconda.
Okay, this is all about extinct and extinct animals.
No, there's a little more. And they are more extinct animals than all of the animals that exist on.
So none of them are extinct animals in this case?
No.
All are extinct.
All are extinct. So this is Titanoboa, largest snake. We have the Thoracic Kraken. The Thoracic Kraken, most of the people agree this is just a theory because there is a guy called Monek Menamin who found some fossils in Nevada, and he's this just a hypothetical theory. He said that the Thoracic Kraken really exists in Nevada, the United States. Now most people agree on this, although some do. And then we have terror birds, yes, it's also called this bird that I can't pronounce. So that's terror birds. And then we have scone birds deer. It was native to Thailand and found by German explorer Sir Robert H. Scone deer, who was knighted in 1844. We have Scombirds deer. And then we have Dumplestius. It has one of the most powerful bifurces in the world. Doesn't have the most powerful bifurce in the Leopardon. This sea creature lived way before the dinosaurs and way before the Leopardon. Yes, it lived during the Devonian period, around 380 million years ago. Then, this is Dumplestius. I found it very hard to write it, it's very long. And then we have the Pinta Island Tortoise, and so on. There's only a male tortoise of the Pinta Island Tortoise called Lonesome George he was the last subspecies. He died in 2015. Then we have the Mandarin large boy butterfly. Mandarin is actually some chains of islands that belong to Portugal. So this is the Mandarin white butterfly. And then we have the Javan tiger. So this is a tiger. The Javan tiger went extinct during the 1950s as the island of Java, Indonesia was developing. The island people also considered this tiger as a pest. So this is the Javan tiger. When we have the bar in the way, yeah, it's very, nobody might know this. The barring wren was the species of a bird family called Rallidae. It was endemic to Fiji actually, and was last collected in 1890. Yeah, so this is the barring wren. I wrote this one night. So we then have the Lubana bird, which is related, which is it belongs to Africa. I don't know, but the name sounds like it's from Africa. Yeah, it's very very short. But the Cetotherium is the most shortest in our world. And then we have Siberian unicorn. Yes. It's not a unicorn or something, it's the great ancestor of rhinos. And you will not go near it, it has the same size of an elephant. Yes, a rhino, a normal rhino that exists today is smaller than an elephant. But this rhino was bigger than a normal elephant and bigger than the mammoth. It was so big that his womb was reaching to the elephant's shoulder. It's very tall. I like this animal. It died out because of the climate change. Just like the human. It also lived in Kazakhstan, places like Kazakhstan, Pakistan, Tajikistan. So this is a Siberian unicorn. Pretty long, but I like this animal. And we have Tengkorka puffish, native of hot springs of the Mejong Desert, has the distinction of being the first animal declared extinct under the provisions of the Endangered Species Act of 1973. The puffish declined participated when precipitated when its natural habitat was encroached upon by developers. Then we have Paoli. It's native to Maui, Hawaii. Yes, it's near the volcano in called Hala Kela. I can't read it, it's a blind word. So this is the Tengkorka puffish and this is Paoli. As you can see, I reached the starting, it's 5 and 6. Now I have the Carolina parakeet, the fourth animal I have a bird. The Carolina parakeet was the only bird of its kind native to the eastern portion of the US. The last Carolina parakeet died at a zoo called Cincinnati Zoo in February of 1918, soon after his name, Mary Jane passed away. Then we have Mosasaur, the first reptile I ever wrote, my favorite reptile, and the third animal I ever wrote. Yes, so Mosasaurus. Yeah, so Mosasaurus was actually was not an enemy of Megalodon, but their size were pretty similar. The only thing is that they are not that big, very flat, and the Megalodon is quite as they are shark. The Mosasaur, as the Jurassic Park is not that big, you would be taller as his mouth, and then you can still find the later snakes and monitor lizards. Then we have the saber-tooth tiger. It's a tiger, but if you didn't know, as its name saber-tooth tiger, it's not closely related to tigers, it's actually closely related to jaguars. You see, saber-tooth tigers have a long teeth from their upper jaws, and it's like a very long, it's not that long, but it's very, it was very dangerous. And nobody would like this animal if it really exists. But it would be cool. But the difference is that if you look into a saber tooth tiger for skull and a jaguar skull, you can see that saber tooth tiger has a skull coming from his upper, there's a long teeth coming from his upper jaw, and the jaguar also has teeth coming from its upper jaw, but it's a little bit smaller, that's all. And then we have my favorite extinct animal, and that is, any guesses? So what animal does come to your mind when extinct animals, when you hear extinct animals?
Dinosaurs.
Yeah, also an example. But my example would be the woolly mammoth. My first animal that I ever wrote and my favorite animal. It's an enormous mammal. It's actually closely related to Asian elephants, as I said. It's not related to African elephants. The relatives of African elephants are the Nilotherium and some other elephants that came from the evolution of elephants. Okay, so you might be thinking that these elephants vanished millions of years ago, but they vanished just recently in 1700 BC. Yes, that's when the Indian, that's when the Indus Valley collapsed. According to scientists, they were last seen in Wrangel Island in the Arctic Ocean around 7000 BC. They could weigh over 6 tons. They were covered in fur, so that you see, elephants cannot live in cold conditions. But these mammoths could, as they had thick coats of fur. Their tusk could easily be up to 5 meters long. The woolly mammoth eventually disappeared 10,000 years ago through a combination of hunting by humans and the disappearance of its habitat through climate change. Yes, just like the Siberian unicorn, as I said, the woolly mammoth also was extinct by climate change.
Is that all?
Yes, but I am pretty more coming soon after I write enough, like I'll write 15 and then we will take a new video.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.